Season 1 second update finally released, and this is my impression. So far, I'm very satisfied with the content, especially the 400% invasion infiltration operation missions, ETA 0, and the new ultimate descendant, Freyna. I really enjoy the 400% invasion missions because of the massive mob density. This is a challenging place and a very good place to test how good your descendant builds. We also get a lot of rewards from doing this content. This is where you can get the standard ETA voucher for ETA 0, which I will talk about later. I also like the changes to the experience and weapon experience gained in the 400% missions. In less than an hour, you can now max a descendant and a weapon easily, which is really convenient. I also like that the missions are accessible 24/7, meaning you can play two specific 400% invasion missions any time of the day. The missions will change every day and it has a rotation, so we will not get bored doing the same missions over and over again. ETA 0 is finally here and we finally get to see what this NPC has for sale. I was able to buy inventory slots and descendant slots, which are massive. If you guys don't know, descendant slots can only be obtained by buying them in the cash shop, but now we get to buy them in the ETA 0 shop, which is really nice, and I'm really glad that the developers did this. As for the prices, it is really easy to obtain the tickets. All you have to do is complete a couple of 400% invasion infiltration operation missions, which will take around 4 to 5 minutes depending on your group composition. You can also sell your excess blueprints, descendant materials, or weapon materials for premium ETA vouchers. What's amazing is that you can sell blueprints that are not needed, including all the excess heli materials that we have just gathered just by playing the invasion infiltration operations every day. I really thought that you can only exchange weapon blueprints and not descendant blueprints, because in the ETA 0 tweet, it specifically stated that you can exchange surplus weapon blueprints and it did not mention descendant blueprints. I have a lot of excess heli parts and I was able to sell it and use the currency to buy other stuff in the market. You can also buy paints and hair paints, which is amazing. The stuff on the market is limited and I do understand that if the developers give us everything, then we won't have anything to do in the game. I think that the ETA 0 NPC is there to lighten the grind by providing us with blueprints that are kind of hard to get. The NPC will always appear every Friday to Sunday, which is really convenient. I finally got my ultimate Freyna, and as of right now, it is currently in research in the Research Institute. It took me around 6 hours of grinding to get all the materials. I did get RNG carried because I got most of the materials pretty easy and the rest took me around 20 plus runs. For the ultimate Freyna enhanced cells blueprint, I got it from Amorphous Material Pattern 119 Variant AB in Fortress Frozen Valley. I farmed 10 amorphous materials and I got it in my first try. For the ultimate Freyna stabilizer blueprint, I farmed Amorphous Material Pattern 97 Variant AB in Caligo, Oswari. I think I had around 26 amorphous material patterns and I did 13 hard swamp walker until I finally got the stabilizer blueprint. For the ultimate Freyna spiral catalyst blueprint, I farmed the Amorphous Material Pattern 54 Variant AB from Kingston Strategic Outpost. I had 10 and I got it on my third run. For the ultimate Freyna code, I got it from doing Sterile Land the Forgottens. I did a lot of descendant and weapon leveling on this mission and I ended up with a lot of Amorphous Material Pattern 67 Variant AB. And it took me one run to get the ultimate Freyna code by defeating Dead Bride. For the new Void Intercept battle, I still haven't done it yet because I've been leveling some weapons, descendants, and farming other stuff. I was also testing a couple of builds that can do the 400% invasion missions efficiently and without dying. The new 400% missions are a game changer, especially if you want to solo the mission, which is not recommended. Soloing 400% missions is incredibly hard, especially missions that have freeze status. getting frozen over and over again will always end up in a failed run. But you can simply circumvent this by using anti-freeze solution. But at the same time, this usually ends up in breaking the build just for these types of mission. For the new Void Intercept Battle Deathstalker, I will make a quick guide on this in the future, so please subscribe so you guys won't miss it. I will probably make the guide after I finish crafting Ultimate Freyna. My plan is to use Ultimate Freyna for the new boss fight and figure things out along the way. Overall, the Season 1 second update is pretty fun and I highly recommend that you guys play the game. The 400% invasion missions are very satisfying and fun. Also, do not forget to buy the things that you need in the ETA Zero shop, especially the inventory and descendant slot. And last but not the least, do not forget the Freyna questline and also good luck with your ultimate Freyna grind. All in all, the Season 1 second update is pretty amazing and I really had fun with its content. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.